I'm Gladys Shao from Tanzania.
What if I told you it was all meant to be? Would you believe me? Would you agree? It's almost that feeling that we've met before. So tell me that you don't think.
Miss USIU 2010 to 2011, Gladys Shao is a description of true beauty. From her smile to her laugh, it's easy to pick her out from a crowd. Born to a family of three children, the beauty queen is no visitor to Kenya.
I can say I grew up in Kenya because I only used to go home over the holidays. Most of the time I used to be in Kenya for school and stuff.
During her free time, Miss Shao does not only dedicate herself to modeling, but has an infinite list of passions.
Spending time with my friends, that's what I love most. You know, chilling, going to the movies, going shopping and stuff like that. Yeah, I can't really say I have a specific type of food that I like, because today I can wake up, I want to eat this, tomorrow I can wake up, I want to eat this. So I can't really say I have one specific type of food, because I think food is just tastes nice. It depends on where you eat it and how it's made. Yeah,
okay,
but I love the song of Rihanna and Drake. Yeah, is it What's My Name, something like that. Yeah, that's my current favorite song. And my favorite color is purple. It just happens that, let's say, my best outfit is purple, like it always comes in purple. My best shoe is purple. Not that I plan it to be, but it just happens.
To all the men wondering if Miss Shao is taken.
I have a boyfriend. He's not in this unit, though. He's in Strathmore. Yeah. We've been dating since I was in high school.
Beauty goes hand in hand with fashion, and Gladys knows it better.
I don't wear something I've seen someone wear. I just wear something that looks nice on me, and people always like it. When you talk about celebrities, there are always people who put those clothes for them together to wear. It's never always their idea.
Yeah.
So you can't really say that, oh my God, I like this person's style. It's someone who always tells her, you have to wear this today, you have to wear this tomorrow, and stuff like that. All the pageants I did back at home, I was always number two, always till the end. So I never knew how it felt to win. So I was like, okay, I came here one day, they were training, and I saw the guys, I'm like, okay, let me just do this. I know I'm going to win. So yeah, so that's why I decided to do it, yeah. Because it's not just about the looks, you know. Yeah, fine, I was among the shortest contestants, but, you know, luckily in my country, they don't really consider height that much, yeah. Because it's not a, you know, runway thing, you know. Beauty pageant is just about, you know, beauty, I think, with brains and, you know, being able to, to have confidence and, to express yourself and stuff.
A beauty crown comes with responsibility.
When we were contesting the Miss and Miss, one girl who was also contesting had sickle cell anemia. So we thought, like, after the event, whoever is going to win, I think that's what we're going to do. Like, try to find an organization or a charity organization that, you know, keeps the anemic people, and see, you know, what can be done to actually help them, you know, anything we can do with the money that we're going to be getting.
Getting the limelight comes with many drawbacks. Gladys does not fall short of this.
Not necessarily a stalker, but just some hater, you know, composed a message about me and sent it to people and stuff, yeah. It was bad because, you know, almost everyone in this school got that message, you know, and it was something so, so bad. Very, 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 very bad. Like, if someone else saw it, just because I don't really want to say that I'm really, really strong or something, but, you know, I just knew that, you know, fame always has a price, so, yeah.
Gladys is not only a beauty queen, but an inspiration to men.
Someone has any dream, don't be scared to, you know, always go for it, because you never really, really know what's going to happen. And see, like, now you guys came from wherever you came all this way to interview me, you know, it feels nice that at least someone decides to, you know, want to do it, just do it, and don't go that, okay, what's going to happen if I don't win and stuff like that, because you never know, you know, what's going to happen. And above all, there are so many challenges that come after all this. But then again, you just have to understand that there are always those people beside you who would always make you feel bad. They don't really like you, you know, because of who you are and stuff like that. They really envy you and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And it's always friends, close friends, funny enough. But,
yeah,
you know, that's just how life is. It always goes on.
was all meant to be. Would you believe me?